woke up, the price of coke up. I just hit them with the low cut, then call my folks up. Somebody about to get poked up, go call a tow truck. All that talking out your neck might just get your throat cut. This a Mack truck, not a black truck. When we move, tell them back up.
Hello everybody, welcome to my very first YouTube channel. And this YouTube, I'm going to be talking about me wanting to become a mom, me giving advice to younger girls, and makeup tutorials as well, get ready with me's and everything like that. Now, I know everybody is wondering, who is Justice Smith? Like, you know, like, what does she bring to the table? Who is she? Well, my name is Justice. It's Justice Smith. My mother, she named me after Poetic Justice, the movie. I think my name is very unique, very different, although a lot of people have that name, but it's not like mine. But I decided to become, not become a YouTuber, but to do YouTube because I feel like it could help me promote my modeling career. So I'm very interested in this stuff. Like, I'm excited to be doing this. I got 92 subscribers already within a day. And I'm just very excited to be doing this. You know, I'm trying to get my social media followings up, and I'm just doing this because I'm very interested in it. So I'm going to be doing Q&A's. I do have a paper with my questions written down on them. People did ask me a few questions today, not a lot of questions, but I'm also going to be talking about y'all getting to know me and where I'm from and how I view things in life, you know, just me giving advice and overall just me opening up to my subscribers and being like a big sister to y'all. And like, just I've always wanted people to know who I was, and I want people to get to know me, and I want people to know that I was here and that I was a loving person. And that I'm just, you know, I'm a very positive person. I like to succeed, and I like all the good things that come behind that. You're gonna find out my age. You're gonna find out so much things about me that you did not know about. So, when did you first know that you'd be into hair and makeup? Well, I knew that I was gonna be into hair and makeup whenever I would say like around middle school, because I started to wear makeup. Like, I just started to wear it because I was interested in it. Like, I would always wear eyeshadow and stuff like that, so I knew I was into makeup. And like, I just always saw like girls with makeup, but I never really knew what I was doing. I just would try to, like, you know, like, see if I could do something like that. So hair, it was always okay. Like, my mom would always take me to the braid shop and get my hair braided, but I never really liked the braids because I just didn't like it. I used to go to the beauty shops, and that was when I was like young, so you know, I had to get my hair done. It was mandatory. So like, whenever I got older, whenever I got into high school, everybody started doing wigs. It was freshman year. I got my first sew-in in eighth grade. It's freshman year, and I got me a wig. It was a curly wig, and it wasn't the prettiest wig, but it was a wig. I didn't know what I was doing. People used to always tell me, "Justice, your lace showing, this showing," and I used to be like, "So," because to me, I knew what I was doing, and I just felt like they was talking about me, but they was trying to help me. So as time went by, from freshman year to senior year, I elevated with like doing my own hair, because you know, we didn't have it like that. I was a cheerleader in school, so I was trying to pay for my cheer. It was $1,000, and I was as well trying to like get my hair done and stuff like that. And you know, so I just was like, okay, I'm gonna order a wig, because why would I pay $200 for the wig and $200 for somebody to put it in, you know, especially if you want it done right. So I just thought I'd start doing that. And I was never in school, like, I was never like the prettiest girl. I was pretty, but I wasn't the prettiest girl. And I never wore nails. I never got my toes done or nothing like that. I was scared to show my toes because I thought that my toes was so ugly. And till I started getting them done, I was like, okay, my toes are really pretty. And like, I just never really thought about getting my nails done because, you know, I was just like, what do I need that for, you know? So I've always been a very conceited person. My friends used to tell me all the time, oh, Justice, you're conceited, you're this. And I just used to be like, I'm always in the camera, like, you know, taking pictures, just like, and I always want people to take pictures for me. And I never knew that modeling never crossed my mind, because it was like, in school, I used to like music. I was very into music. I was doing talent shows. I even went to Atlanta once. I was very into music. It was something that I wanted to do, because just music is so powerful to me. Like, J. Cole, Lauryn Hill, Jagged Edge, like, I was so into it. Like, I loved it. Beyonce, Kehlani, like, those people inspired me, and they still inspire me to this day. So those people inspired me to do music. But as time went by in school, I grew apart from it. And it was something that I realized, okay, you don't want to do this. You're not being consistent enough to do this. So, everybody was figuring out what college they was going to. And I was a cheerleader, and all the cheerleaders was like, oh, I'm going to UT Austin. Oh, I'm going here. I'm going there. And it was just like, I didn't know much about college. So I ended up applying for Blinn Junior College, because it was a junior college. I didn't want to be close by home, so I didn't apply to the nearby junior college close by home. So I applied to Blinn. It's kind of by Houston. It's like 30 minutes from Houston. It's two to 3 hours away from home for me. So I'm kind of far from home. But I applied for Blinn. My major is psychology. I chose psychology because I felt like I wanted to always give advice to people. I want to help people, and I just want to be there for people and for kids that go through stuff. Like, I want to do that. I'm interested in stuff like that as well. And after I applied for college, you know, I got accepted. So, boom. I knew when I did something, I wanted to do it. Like, I wanted to be the best at it. Like, if I do something, I'm coming with a bang. So, like, it was senior pictures time. Everybody's taking senior pictures. And remind you guys that me and my mom, we don't have the best relationship, because I feel like she could have did better than what she was doing for me during senior year. And it just wasn't clicking. So, but I still love her, though. But it's just something she could have did better for herself and for me. But, you know, life isn't all peaches and cream. So, it was time to take senior pictures. You know, everybody getting their senior pictures took. And I was like, oh, like, I know for a fact I'm finna kill this. So, I was like, I'm going up. So, my friends was like, Justice, why are you trying to pay $400 for senior pictures? And it was just like, if I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it right. So I paid out of my pocket, because I was a server at the time. I like working as a server. It's fun to me. I plan on working at Hooters this summer of 2020. I plan on working at Hooters or something. I contacted Marcus. He's a great photographer. He's worked with Tyra Banks. He's worked with a lot of people. And I remember looking at his Instagram, and I was like, oh my God, my pictures are gonna be so beautiful. So I contacted him, and I was like, hey, how much? And he was like, $400, $200 deposit. Then you can give me the other $200 whenever. So I was like, okay. I worked my tail off for those pictures. I went to work. I worked the doubles for those pictures. Boom, I took my senior pictures. The day I dropped my senior pictures, everybody was like mouth drops. Like, everybody mouth was dropped. Everybody was shook. They was like, oh my God, you look so beautiful. And I was like, I remember looking at the pictures, like, look at my legs. Like, cause I'm 5'9". I was like, oh my God, I'm so beautiful. And I remember I was just posing, like looking, making a soft pose. And I was like, and people was like, you should do modeling. And I was like, no, because I don't know, I just never really just thought about it like that. And it was like, you should do modeling. And I never thought about it. I was like, I don't know if I want to do modeling. Never really thought about it. Came to school, college, it just never crossed my mind. I've always been a photogenic person. I'm always like, take me a picture right here, do this right here, posing like this, posing like that. And my grandma and them make jokes, and they'd be like, oh, you must think you a model, this and this and that. And it's just like, so I never really thought about it like that. So I lost touch with music. I came to college, and you know, I just met different people. People was doing different things. Because where I'm from Palestine, Texas. It's a very country town. Not much city. We don't have a mall. So it was like, you know, I didn't know much about the city unless I saw it on social media. And I saw the city and I was like, ooh, this looks like, this is a dream. Like, this is everything I want. So, I chose Bland because I kind of wanted to be close by Houston, because after Bland, I plan on going to University of Houston because I want to see what it's like in Houston. And if Houston doesn't work out for me, I do plan on living my life in Atlanta. So we're going to skip through that. And so I came to college or whatever, and I'm just doing my studies. Boom. Christmas break comes and I'm at home. I'm just sitting on the couch and I'm just watching music videos because, again, I'm interested in music. And I'm looking at these models like Bernice Burgos. I'm just looking at her and I'm just like, oh, she's like the way she's coming out of the water and like how she looks. And I'm just like, oh, my God, that woman is beautiful. Like, and then I'm seeing her walk with her swimsuit looking all beautiful and like seductive. And I was just like, I could do that. So I remember hearing something about video vixens and I was like, I'm pretty enough. I got it. I could be a video vixen. And I was just like, oh my God, I got this. Like, I could do this. So I started looking more into models and video vixens. And, you know, I hear a lot of bad things that they say about them. Like, they're, I hear that they're hoes and they're this and they're that. But I think it's all about what kind of work you want to do. I don't judge people, but it's all about what kind of work you want to do. And so yeah, I was looking at that and I was like, I told my god sister, I was like, I think I want to be a model. And she was like, do it. She was like, go for it. And I was like, I'm gonna have to really go for it, because, you know, my cousin was like, it's a lot of girls that want that same spot. They want to be the main girl. They want to be the prettiest. And it's just not about being the prettiest to me. It's not all about looks to me. I feel like I don't have to have sex with a man to get, you know, a part in life that I want. I feel like I'm smart enough and I'm educated enough to actually, you know, just work hard and get it for myself. So I chose modeling because I think that I'm very poised. I'm very beautiful. I have a very soft, resting face. I have a great personality, fun, outgoing, and I'm good with people. As far as I know, everybody, you know, kind of like me. Some people look up to me. Some people don't like me, but I can only remain myself at the end of the day. So I chose modeling. That's why I chose modeling. And another question I have is, they're asking me about makeup tutorials, shopping online, and again, what inspired me to become a model. With makeup tutorials, I used to do them, but I never really took it serious. I am going to start doing makeup tutorials. I'm going to be like doing Get Ready With Me's, first college makeup, you know, just doing makeup. This is a very basic face that I do. Like, I don't do much, don't do eyeshadow, just a very basic face I do for everyday makeup. So yeah, that's with the makeup. And then shopping online. Honestly, my money is all gone because of Fashion Nova. I love Fashion Nova. Fashion Nova is the best shopping site to shop online. And I like Pretty Little Thing as well. Fashion Nova is very cheap and it's very like, you can get whatever you want. Like, it's, they have everything. So it's like, I spend like $100 on Fashion Nova. And I'm just like, I could've used that for something else, but it's like, no, Fashion Nova. And my package comes in and I'm just trying on my clothes and stuff like that. I will be doing more dress up hauls. I will be, you know, showing you guys what I got on for today, or showing you guys how this fits on me, how that fits on me, my opinions on their clothes. And actually, I'm going to be doing opinions on other clothes too as well. So it's not all about Fashion Nova. It's about other clothes. Just Fashion Nova is one of them because I love Fashion Nova. I like Fashion Nova a lot. So again, what inspired me to become a model? Just being beautiful. Just realizing like you could be the face. You could be the face. Like, you could be that if you want to. You could do that. And I want to talk about my background, because, you know, most people don't know me. Most people claim they know me. Most people say this. I hear stuff all the time, but it's like, no, that's not true. So we're going to start off with my age and my birthday. My birthday is January 15th, 2000. I was born in the year 2001. I am currently 19 years old. I just turned 19, January the 15th. People always tell me that I look older than what I am. Yes, I'm 19. Some people be like, oh, you look 21. Oh, you look this. Oh, you look that. I'm actually 19. I think people tell me that because I'm 5'9". I'm literally 5'9". And people are always like, how tall are you? And I'm like 5'9". And boys be like, dang, you tall. So it's just like, I've been tall all my life. And it's okay. Sometimes I used to wish I was short, but I've grown to love my body and my legs. Sometimes I get a little insecure, but it's, as far as I'm concerned, of like, I don't get insecure very much. Like, I think I'm very a conceited, humble person. Like, I could look at myself and I love myself. My favorite feature about myself are my teeth. I've never had braces. I don't know how my teeth got this pretty. I've never had braces, and so yeah, my teeth are my favorite. Then I'm going to be talking about boys. I'm single person in my life. I've never really had a real boyfriend like that. Never had a Valentine's. Never, I didn't have a prom day. I just didn't do that stuff. Like, I don't know, I didn't have a boyfriend. Like, I've had a boyfriend, but it was never one of those relationships where it was like, oh my god, they've been together since high school and now they're together now. My longest relationship was a month. So that should let you know how I am with the guys. Now, don't get me wrong, guys are okay, but right now I'm at a point in life where it's like, I'm doing everything for me. You know, I'm focusing on myself and I'm just doing this all for me. So it's just like, yeah. Social media. I really do want my social media gaining to go up, shoot up. I want a crazy fan base. Like, I've always wanted people to support me because I never got much support from my mom. That's a big reason why we're not close. And my dad, you know, we're just not close. So like, I don't really get a lot of support from people. That's why I go so hard for myself. Like, I try my best to stay on top. Like, you gotta do this for yourself, because bro, nobody cares about this but you. So like, do it for yourself, don't do it for nobody else. I wanted to talk about my favorite things to do and my favorite food. My favorite things to do, I like to shop. Like, take me to a mall, I'm going to shop to a job. Like, I'm gonna be walking at the mall with all my bags like this, literally falling to the ground. I love to shop. I love to go to parties. I like going out to eat. You know, we can walk and look at lights. I like city. I'm not from the city, I'm from the country, but I love city things. Like, I just like it. I think it's so neat how, you know, like, it's the city. Like, you know, everything you want in a dream is right there. So I think that it's very nice. And I like to take pictures. I like to, what else do I like to do? I like to do my makeup. I like watching movies. I like watching other people do stuff like that. I like watching people succeed. I like planning out my goals. Sometimes I even like typing. I don't know, I think typing is fun. So like, when I'm doing an essay, I'm just like typing. I like doing that stuff. I like riding in cars because I just think it's soothing. I like going to the nail shop. I like getting my nails done. I like being pampered. I love that stuff. That's what I like to do. My favorite food would have to be street tacos. I love street tacos. Like, oh my God, street tacos are so good. I like nachos, and my favorite drink is Snapple. snapple. Like lemonade is so good to me. Like, and I've been laying low on soda. I haven't drunk soda in probably about 3 to 2 weeks because, you know, I'm trying to watch my weight. And I feel like soda is a big part of why people, you know, lose control of their body and their weight. So I've been drinking Snapple and water. So I feel great about that. And then hopefully I'm gonna slow down on meat soon, but not too soon. Cause look, I gotta eat meat. So yeah, that's pretty much the things I like to do. I wanted to talk about leaving Palestine. So for me, leaving Palestine was kind of emotional because that's like my family is there, like my mom is there, my grandma is there, and I had best friends. And it was very sad because it was like, you got to do this for yourself. Like, stop being a wimp. Like, you have to do this for yourself, not nobody else. So things got bad after I graduated high school with my mother. Like, it was always rumors that, you know, she was on drugs, or, you know, it was this, it was that. And it was just like everything was piling on me at once. And it was like, I just graduated. Like, she was late to my graduation. She didn't look the same anymore. Like, it's like I would look at her and it was like, bro, you don't look like yourself. So I would look at her and I would just be like, bro, you don't look like yourself. So we would get into it about that. And I decided to leave. It was my plan to leave anyways, because I didn't want to be in the country. I didn't want to be in Palestine. I wanted to go to the city. I want to be in the city. I'm trying to get closer to, you know, I'm trying to leave. I'm not trying to be stuck. Like, I'm not a content person. I'm not okay with just being okay. I want more in life. So it's like, that's who I am. So we wasn't close and things got bad. So I left and I went to Tyler, which is like a 30-minute drive. It's bigger than Palestine, but that's not where I want to reside. I went to Tyler and I stayed with my godparents because it was college. It was like fall was coming up. College is coming. So yeah, I did that. I got me a job. I worked a 9-to-5 literally. Matter of fact, not even a 9-to-5. I worked from 7 o'clock in the morning to 4 o'clock in the evening, Monday through Friday. I paid for all my stuff, my college stuff, everything I have in my room. I paid for it, clothes, you know, everything. So it was like I did all that for myself. I felt great when I moved to college. My godparents dropped me off at college. She drove her own car and came. You know, she was still in the picture, but it was kind of like, yeah, all right, you here. So, I did that for myself, but it was like, you're my mother, but you're not here. You get what I'm saying? Like, you're here, but you're not always here for me. You're not always by my side. Like, I can't go to her and cry because it's more of like a tough love situation. It's like, why are you crying? Like, you don't cry. You're supposed to thug it out. So it's like, me and my mom don't have a close relationship. So sometimes that hurts. So I just want to talk about that. We do talk sometimes, but it's like, I love her, but it's like if I went months without talking to her, it wouldn't faze me. Like, I love her though, but it's just like we don't have that bond. And my dad, me and my dad are not close. It's something about me that makes me feel, it makes me feel lost. It's something I feel lost, like, because he's not here. Like, it's a hole in my heart because it's like I'm supposed to be daddy's little girl, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, you wasn't here. My dad was on drugs bad, you know, so he was trying to recover, but I still feel like you don't want to recover, you don't want to help yourself. So I just gave up, you know, I gave up. Now, I'm one person I'm close with in my life is my grandmother, Emily. I love you to the day I die. We are like this. Like, when I left for college, boy, like, we cried and cried. Like, I remember one day she came to see me because, you know, I left Palestine. And, like, I didn't see my family. Like, I wasn't with them. And we saw each other. And she called me. And she was like, I'm outside. So I came outside. And I gave her a hug and I was like, you going to church? And she was like, yeah. And I hugged her and we were saying that like we love each other and stuff like that. And I was like, okay. Like, no, I was fighting back my tears because I didn't want to cry in front of her. Like, I don't cry in front of her. Like, people don't see me cry. So I told her I loved her. And she got in her car and I went back in the house. And I remember just thinking, oh my God, like, I was gonna cry in front of this woman. Like, no, I'm not gonna cry. So she FaceTimed me. I was like, I didn't think she was gonna FaceTime me. So she FaceTimed me and I looked at the camera and she looked at the camera and she was like, what's wrong? And I said nothing. And she started crying and I started crying. I was like, oh, freak, bro. Like, no. And I was just like, I love you. And she was like, I love you too. But she was like, I know that like you wanna like, you know, you wanna do something great with your life. So go be great. Like, don't stay around for me. Like, don't stay around. Because like it's nothing here in Palestine. So I didn't stay in Palestine. Although it hurt me a lot because I wanted to be with my grandma. Like, I love her. Like, I wanna look at the part about leaving Palestine. It's because, you know, people think I changed it. People think I'm a different person. People think that I got like bougie or whatever, but it's not that. It's just that everything I do for me. Like, I don't let nobody determine my success. And it just hurts me so much because I love my grandma like so much. And I didn't want to leave her behind. And I know she didn't want me to leave her behind because we're like this. So I had to leave. And it was like I had to leave for me. Like, I had to do what was best for me. So that was my little emotional part about leaving home. I'm not scared to be on my own. I do everything for myself. It's just that the love and the connection that we have for each other is like I would never do anything to hurt her or let anybody hurt her. My siblings, I have a brother named Keondis, Destiny, and Keon on my mom's side. And on my dad's side, I have a sister named Kiana, Shannon, and Safira. My closest sibling is my brother Kiki. Like, we're like this. If something was to happen to him, I would be devastated. Like, I love him so much. And I think it's because we grew up together. Like, it was five of us, and it's never always been five of us at home. It's just been me and him. The other ones, like, they stay with my aunts and stuff like that. So, me and Kiki are very close. I love him. He is 13 years old. I look after him, like, we're tight. But he stays with his godmom in Houston, which I think is great because I don't want him in Palestine. Like, I don't want my brother to grow up in Palestine. I want him to be in Houston. I want him to see, look, bro, like, this is it. Like, you want this, go get it. Like, you don't need to be in Palestine. So, yeah, that's who I'm closest with. I'm gonna talk about how I have a great personality. My personality is 10 out of 10 because I feel like I'm a real person with myself and to other people. Like, I've never tried to be something I'm not. Everything I do is because I feel like that's who I am. I like making people laugh. I'm a genuine person, a very sweet, humble person, humble but cocky person. I love making new friends. I'm very easy to get along with. I'm very loving, you know. You can come talk to me about anything. I'm a kind person. I'm always understanding. You know, people go through a lot. And I want people to know that you're not alone. There's help if you need help. Like, it's okay. People think that getting emotional is weird. Crying is weird. It's not weird. We're humans. We have feelings. Don't try to act like you don't have feelings because that's when you're hurting yourself. So that's pretty much what I have to say about my personality. This video was a very crazy video. Overall, I recovered. why I want to become a model, and me leaving home, college life, guys, me wanting to give young girls advice, makeup tutorials in the future, and high school, and you know, just becoming who I am as a woman. So if you guys are excited and ready to take this journey with me, with starting my modeling career and starting my YouTube channel, please subscribe and just please, you know, come watch my videos, you know, tell me what you want me to talk about. I will talk about that. I would do that. Like, it's not a problem. My channel. Thank you guys so much for watching.